mead makers are enhancing this ancient beverage with everything from spices and herbs to local fruit, like raspberries, pears, rhubarb, and even the little-known pawpaw. So we're here at Marc Boone's farm to learn more about this native fruit. Marc Boone is the local pawpaw grower in town. I feel like everybody who knows about pawpaws knows Marc. He has this beautiful orchard. So how many pawpaw trees do you have?
About 300.
Oh, wow.
These are the grafted pawpaws. Mm-hmm. I planted them in 1988.
Being a native tree and a native fruit, it still is pretty relatively unknown. Tell me about what it tastes like, the pawpaw. It's such an unusual flavor.
If you can imagine a mix of apple and peach and mango with no acid in it, it's hard to imagine because all those fruit have kind of a nice acidic bite to them as well as a sweetness. Mm-hmm. But drop out the acid and it's got all those other flavors in it.
A pawpaw to me tastes like something that shouldn't grow in Michigan, but it does. It is native to this area. We're kind of at the northernmost edge of where the pawpaws grow, but it's sweet and tropical and the texture is kind of custardy. So we kind of press it by hand and then we small batch ferment mead with it and just kind of let it naturally sour with the kind of yeast and bacteria that's on the skins of those pawpaws.